I'm Bryce Lowery, Assistant Professor of Regional and City Planning at the University of Oklahoma College of Architecture. In this video, I'll be discussing vulnerability assessments. Vulnerability assessments are an increasingly valuable tool that helps residents, organizations, agencies, businesses, and policymakers identify what are their greatest vulnerabilities to climate change. This information is used to plan and build resilient communities. Vulnerability assessments may take many forms and be conducted in a variety of ways. Most often, the process entails identifying opportunities and assets, cataloging weaknesses and constraints, prioritizing possible actions based on available resources, and mitigating sources of vulnerability. Vulnerability assessments are a common starting point for communities interested in increasing their resilience to climate-induced risks such as extreme heat, drought, and sea level rise. Vulnerability assessments focus on three different dimensions of resilience: economic, social, and environmental. Economic vulnerability measures the resilience of financial services, economic policies, capital available in a community, number of jobs, and employment opportunities. Measures often include rates of home ownership, indebtedness, housing costs, rates of employment, revenues, and rates of public and private investment. The strength of these factors is believed to help communities through periods of financial crisis. Social vulnerability measures the resilience of community health and well-being, social support, and quality of life. Measures of social resilience include indicators of incidence and prevalence of disease, crowding and isolation, educational attainment and opportunities, networks of family and social support, access to transportation and services such as healthcare, parks, and grocery stores. A robust social system is crucial in the wake of a natural disaster or other catastrophic event because residents may need to rely on each other and nearby amenities to support recovery. Environmental vulnerability measures the resilience of the physical and natural environment. The geographic structure of the area, as well as climatic patterns and the occurrence of severe weather, earthquakes, and flooding are typically considered in the assessment. Additional measures may include ecosystem and species health, the production of energy, food, and goods, construction techniques and materials, and the presence of dangerous substances such as mercury, lead, pollution, and chemicals. The resilience of a community is strengthened through policies that enhance the nearby natural environment and promote design strategies to protect the well-being and vitality of residents. Vulnerability assessments are frequently conducted as part of a comprehensive planning process carried out at the regional, community, or neighborhood scale. They should be both comprehensive and appropriate for the communities involved. They may be carried out broadly to cover a wide range of possible concerns or to focus on a specific issue. A panel of stakeholders from the assessment area usually oversees the vulnerability assessment. They develop a process, timeline, and plan for the assessment. This panel will represent residents, businesses, nonprofit, and for-profit organizations, as well as governmental agencies and representatives whose jurisdictions are part of the assessment area. Often, a thorough assessment requires a year or more to prepare, to provide time to gather and analyze information and report on findings. Implementation of the plan that results is likely to provide a roadmap for future projects aimed at decreasing vulnerability and will likely include short and long-range goals and objectives depending on the scope and the scale of the assessment. There are two main sources of information needed for conducting a vulnerability assessment: community members and administrative data. Administrative data often include counts of things like residents and hazard events, community-level health records, maps of land use, and community resources. Publicly available data, such as information published by the United States Census and data available from state, regional, and local agencies, also play a critical role in helping communities assess their strengths and vulnerabilities. Community members are often engaged using surveys, focus groups, and public meetings. However, more direct community engagement is an increasingly important part of conducting a comprehensive vulnerability assessment. Vulnerability assessments often focus on meaningful dialogue about neighborhood assets and utilize community-led strategies for sharing information such as asset mapping, photo voice, and neighborhood walks to document areas of concern and places of opportunity. Resilience is one measure used for assessing the vulnerability of a community. Resilience refers to the ability of a city, community, or neighborhood to reorganize and adapt following a natural, financial, or social disruption. Neighborhoods that are economically, socially, and environmentally resilient recognize the potential for disruption and prepare to help residents rebound from drastic changes in the systems that provide for the collective health, safety, and welfare. Once the values and vulnerabilities of an area under assessment are identified, the community can discuss opportunities for preserving what it values and reducing vulnerability. For example, many vulnerability assessments are conducted as part of a plan to improve and invest in the infrastructure of a community. Investments in infrastructure resulting from a vulnerability assessment could include physical improvements to transportation, energy, and wastewater management systems. Some communities may choose to invest in green infrastructure, increasing resilience by harnessing the power of natural systems. The evolution of stormwater management strategies provides a good example of using green infrastructure to reduce vulnerability. Historically, runoff from storms was treated as wastewater, collected along streets, and sent to the nearest body of water. Today, stormwater managers collect stormwater and treat it before returning it to the environment. Contemporary stormwater management systems often serve as habitat for flora and fauna and provide a place for social activities and economic opportunity. Communities that have conducted vulnerability assessments may invest in similar strategies that address economic, environmental, and social vulnerability. Looking ahead, it seems likely that regions, neighborhoods, and residents will face increasing pressures from ecological, financial, and social changes taking place in communities everywhere. Vulnerability assessments can prepare cities, towns, and small villages to be more resilient in the face of uncertainty. Ultimately, the sustainability of these places will still be reliant on the willingness of the local community to prepare for the future.